Hello, the topic of this session is flip-flop 2. Summarizing, flip-flops basically comes under the category of sequential circuit which has one or two input and corresponding output along with additional function of reset and clear. The most important memory element in digital system is flip-flop, which is made up of an assembly of logic gates. They are the basic building block of any sequential circuit. The content of this session consists of D flip-flop proceeding with T and JK flip-flop. Starting with the D flip-flop, this is the symbol of D flip-flop. It is also called as D latch because we can construct a latch with a single input which is labeled as D for data. In addition, with the D input, we have one more input called as enable with the two output Q and Q bar as shown in symbol. The circuit diagram proves the working of D flip-flop. The inverted D input is given to another NAND gate. Now we will understand the working with the help of truth table. When EN, that is enable, is low, the latch is ineffective and any change in the value of D input does not affect the output at all. When EN is high, a low D input makes Q low, that is reset the flip-flop, and high D input makes Q high, that is sets the flip-flop. In another words, we can say that the output Q follows the D input when EN is high and Q bar is complement of Q. So this latch is said to be transparent. For the design of sequential circuit, we should know the excitation table also. This excitation table can be obtained by truth table itself. It indicates the required input D which is to be applied to the flip-flop which take it from the present state to the next state. For the given D flip-flop, if present state is 0 and the next state is 0, then the required input D is also 0. In second case, if present state is 0 and next state is 1, then the required input D is 1 and hence further. Age trigger flip-flops. Digital system can operate either synchronously or asynchronously. In asynchronous system, output of logic system can change its state at any time when one or more input changes. In synchronous system, the exact time at which any output can change its state are determined by a signal called as clock. The flip-flop using clock signal is called as clocked flip-flop. The clock signal is distributed to all parts of the system and most of the system output can change its state only when the clock makes the transition. Clock flip-flop may be positive edge trigger or negative edge trigger. Positive edge trigger D flip-flop. Positive edge trigger flip-flop are those in which state transition take place only at a positive going low to high edge of the clock pulse. And negative edge trigger flip-flop are those in which state transition take place at a negative going high to low edge of the clock signal. Positive edge trigger is indicated by a triangle at a clock terminal of flip-flop as shown, and negative edge trigger is indicated by a triangle and the bubble at the clock terminal as shown in figure respectively. Coming to the edge trigger D flip-flop, it has one input data line and clock input. Triangle is present without a bubble, hence it is called as positive edge trigger D flip-flop. Circuit diagram is similar to normal D flip-flop with just a change of enable is replaced by the clock pulse. Coming to the truth table, the operation is similar to normal D flip-flop with the fact that the output Q will go to the same state that is present on the D input at the positive going transition of the clock. Pulse, that means the level at D will be stored in the flip-flop at the instant the positive going transition occur. That is if D is 1 and clock is applied, Q goes to 1 and Q bar goes to 0 at the rising edge of the pulse. If D is 0 and clock is applied, Q goes to 0 and Q bar to 1 at the rising edge of the clock pulse and hence remains so. At each positive level, if according D input is given, then we get the respected output Qn and Qn plus 1. The same working take place with the negative edge trigger D flip-flop with the difference that output transition occurs at the negative edge. Coming to the D flip-flop, as shown in symbol, D flip-flop has a single control input and T symbolizes for toggle. Circuit diagram of this flip-flop is being realized by using NAND gate with clock and T as an input with its respected output. When T is high, the flip-flop toggles, that is, it changes its state from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. When T is low, flip-flop remains in whatever state it was before. With reference to truth table, when T is equals to 0, no change take place, that is, Qn plus 1 is same as Qn. But when T is equals to 1, then the flip-flop toggles, that is, it changes its state from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. Coming to the excitation table, when present state is 0 and next state is also 0, then the required input T is also 0, and further so on. Edge trigger T flip-flop. It has a working similar to the T flip-flop with the difference that it works on the command of clock input. When T is high, the flip-flop toggles on every rising edge of the clock pulse. When T is low, the flip-flop remains in whatever state it was before. This was about positive edge trigger T flip-flop. The negative differs with the fact that transition occurs at falling edge. The last flip-flop is JK flip-flop of this session. JK flip-flop is very versatile and most widely used. The two flip-flop which we have seen till now was having a single input, but JK flip-flop has two inputs, that is J and K. The function of JK flip-flop is identical to that of SR flip-flop except that it has no valid state like that of SR flip-flop. These are the two symbols with the difference that second has additional two input, set and preset. If a constant 1 is held on the preset input, the flip-flop will remain in Q is equals to 1 state regardless of what is occurring at the other input. Similarly, if a constant 1 is held on the clock input, the flip-flop will remain in Q is equals to 0 state regardless of what is occurring at the another input. As shown in circuit diagram, the Q output is again given back to the K and Q bar is given back to the J with clock input. Now let us understand the operation with the help of truth table. When J is equals to 0 and K is equals to 0, no change take place. When J is equals to 0 and K is equals to 1, the flip-flop is reset, that is 0. When J is equals to 1 and K is equals to 0, flip-flop is set, that is 1. When J is equals to 1 and K is equals to 1, flip-flop goes in toggle mode. Excitation table tells us about the preset, the present state, next state and the required J and K.